Two in the French language. There are seven in English and an eighth being written almost as we speak. I'm on it now. I started it in 1984. It took me till 95 to get into print, but I carried on writing them till about 5 years ago when I took a break and started a second series. I've now gone back to Troy. They start there, but they move up as recently as 1963. I've never set two novels in the same year, really. I think he starts out aged about 25, and he's closer to 50 by the time the series reaches its latest point. Second World War slides into the Cold War. All that changes is an adjective. One of the most shocking things about the end of the war in 45 is, by and large, people stopped shooting each other, but people went on dying in their millions. And by 1946, I think there were 12 million people in motion in Europe, which oddly is about the same number of people displaced in the Middle East now. It was years and years before there was anything resembling normality. To draw a line in that era at, what was it, August 45, I can't remember the precise date of the Japanese surrender. It's a definite line in history. It doesn't mean history changed overnight. As a kind of memento mori, I keep my ration book on a shelf above my desk to remind me of the era I was born into just after the war, when there was still food rationing, even for children. Novel Retour de Flamme is set in 1956, which is a pivotal year in the Cold War. Khrushchev visits London for the first time, catches the British spying on the battleship that delivers him, and shortly afterwards, France and Britain invade Egypt, and Russia invades Hungary, and suddenly the world is upside down again. It altered the fortunes of the Communist Party back in Britain. People left in droves, and it drastically altered the relationship between Britain, France, and America, because America caught us playing hooky, if that phrase means something to you. America did not back either your country or mine in the invasion of Suez. And it damaged international relations. And if America was not the most powerful and influential country on earth in 1945, it sure as hell was in 1956.